Late in the night I woke, I was thinking of some other God. And then every night I used to, because that was my favorite problem, I used to think about it a little. How to do it, not come. And then next day, in the morning, something very interesting happened. I was lying on the bed. I woke up. My body was sleeping. My mind was awake. And believe me, I saw a figure of how that algorithm will work in a diagram. This step will happen. And then my limbs became a little loose. I got up, wrote that diagram, I realized that the problem is solved. And I put that diagram in that paper, that is my most cited paper ever. It works. Did you get a heartbreak? Yes. Sent a paper, people said it was done. Just a few days ago, we solved an extremely interesting problem, did a very great mathematics on a reliability problem. We were so overjoyed. We wrote the whole paper out, and then some gut feeling, you know, when you dream about problems, gut feelings happen. I told Aritro, this looks too simple and too beautiful for somebody not to have done it. Look at it. He said, sir, I've searched everything. Finally, see, the internet is so powerful. Finally, we almost had sent the paper. He sent me an SMS, sir, found it, 1968. But we were delighted that we had done it all by ourselves. And we used that same concept and did something different. That same philosophy. And we got another workout in a different area, but it helped us. So you will get heartbreaks. And you'll have to find your own ways to get over. Can you explain your research to others? That is the most important. Two categories. One is really people authoritative in the field, can you explain it to them? The second is to a layperson. Some idea. If you cannot do that, then it becomes a little difficult to understand. So sometimes you must do it. And do you know the research problems of others? If you don't, then your problem. Next. So then I am willing to write a PhD for dummies. How to get a PhD in 3.5 years? First, find a supervisor. How do you find a supervisor? Department allocates. How do you find a supervisor? Y'all can choose, no? So how do you find a supervisor? The person who does your PhD for you, or you know. And then how do you find a topic? The easiest way to find a topic is what is trending, you know, Twitter trending type. And try to tweak it and write some papers. At least find a topic. For that topic, you start studying. Know it. Know that topic well. And unless you know that topic well, you must have heard Dr. Vidyasagar coming and explaining things to you. He's a master of control systems. And because of his great knowledge of control systems, he has used that whole theory in biology. And today, the field of biology is transformed. So your topic must be something that you really do on your own. So first search, then e-search, www, Google, Google Scholar, SciFinder Index. So make sure you know the field. Read. Nowadays, people don't read anything except their own papers. So be careful. Because nobody possibly is reading your paper. But you must start identifying the good things and reading it. And then look at the problem again your way. Look at the same problem your way. You may be very foolish. Try 2-3 times. And then you'll get the handle. That's how we got it. We were looking like fools many times. This is wrong. Everybody would say, his supervisor, no, this is too simple. What are you saying? This theory doesn't work. But then slowly, slowly you'll get a handle. How many problems will you solve for doing a PhD? For dummies, 3. First one, let your supervisor define it and work with your supervisor to solve the problem. Second one, if your supervisor even defines or gives you the problem, solve it on your own. Third one, define that problem yourself. And talk to your supervisor and solve it on your own. And if it is good, if you are good enough, then for the fourth one, define the problem, don't tell your supervisor. At the end you go and tell him that I have done it. How does it look like? That is when you are ready to do your PhD. And make sure the experiments and results are all correct. Please don't fudge the results. Please don't fudge the results. And make sure you are convinced in your own heart that the experiments are correct. And a thesis does not mean you have to only do new things. If you did something which did not work and you have an explanation for why it did not work, even that is part of what a thesis is all about. When and where to publish, I just talked, explained to you. Try to look at the best journals to publish, best places to publish, and then see what reviews you get. When to submit. So there are a lot of theories about when to submit. I will share with you my experience with one of my students. So, he came and said, "Sir, thesis submit concurrently." So I told him, "You will know when you have to submit your thesis." "No, sir, but you have to tell me." I said, "No, you will know when you have to submit your thesis." So then he said, "No, no, sir, you have to tell me when I will be ready to submit the thesis." So I told him, "The day you realize that on this topic you know more than me, then you are ready to submit your thesis." This is something that kabhi nahi hoga, sir, you are PPC, you are great there. No, every day when I go to sleep and when I wake up, two prayers I have. That don't be gassed by others. You know what you are and be careful about what you are. Don't make sure that the others fool you to believe what they think you are is what you are. You are not that. So anyway, so that person, he said, "Ye to kabhi nahi hoga, sir, this will never happen." So I said, "Nahi, nahi, you will realize." So the day he came to submit his thesis, sir signed him. He's working in a good company, great guy. So I'm signing. So I said, "Subrat, you remember?" I said, "Yes, sir." "Are you ready to submit your thesis?" He said, "Yes, sir." "Is my rule correct, what I told you about?" He kept quiet for 2 minutes and then he said, "Yes, sir. I know more about this than you and I'm sure that I know more about it." That is when you have to submit. And please make sure that you are doing teaching. If you are not teaching others, including your supervisor at times, then you are really not doing a service to yourself. You may not be knowing your work unless you start explaining to others what your work is. Next. Final jnan, There are great success stories, but you all, the next generation, fought this country for the sake of the people of this country. We are getting 25,000, 28,000. From where? Where are you getting that money from? From that person who buys a matchbox to light up the fire of his own homes for that one day meal, from that cell tax of that fire matchbox. From the poorest of the poor who buy things, the nation is giving you money in the hope that you will do something for them. Please remember, we all think we deserve all this money. Where is this money coming from? So it is time that the hopes of the nation are with you. And for India, it is time has come for all of you to network together and take on the most challenging problems. And you can only do this when all the IIT scholars come, define these 20 problems and work relentlessly for the next 5-6 years. Can you change this mindset? Can we really take on the world? If ISRO, with that motley of scientists, can change it, what would these IITs do? The 10,000 research scholars in the IITs do? Collaborate, compete, share, use the network. You tell us what you need. Tell us what you need. We may be fossilized. We may have become old. But that dream is still there with us. You know, there are parents who are not educated, but they dream to see their children educated. We have done our bit, but our dream is not successful yet. We will continue to try, and we want you to take this dream forward, dream yourself, and take it forward. Next. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir, for making us understand the word research in total innovative way. I thank you again for taking us to the roots of life. I hope the researchers will certainly imbibe your suggestion into their research work. We heartily thank you, sir.